edition of WCW's Thunder on the Superstation. And Larry, the eyes of the wrestling world are firmly focused on this Sunday Spring Stampede event, where the world's champion Ric Flair, Hollywood Hogan, Diamond Dallas Page, and yes, Sting will vie in a four corners match for the world's title, and the Macho Man Randy Savage will be the special referee.
You know, the irony of it all, Professor, we've got four more days and we've got four of the number one contenders, the cream of the crop, in the ring all at the same time, going for the biggest prize in the business, the heavyweight championship of the world. The unique catch, of course, is Macho Man will be in the middle of it all.
You know, Larry, I've been quite critical of Ric Flair over the course of the past month or so, claiming that he's been hand-picking his opponents. But after what we saw this past Monday on Nitro with the Four Corners match, and the fact that he has agreed to be part of the Four Corners bout with the world title at stake this Sunday at Spring Stampede, I don't think we can make that claim any longer.
You know, it's easy to be critical of people. You know, Shakespeare once said, uneasy lies the head that wears the crown. And I could be very critical of the Nature Boy if I wanted to. He's ran from me for 20 years. But then again, there's got to be ulterior motives. I mean, Ric Flair, no doubt in my mind, wants to do whatever he can to keep the belt away from Men of the Wolf.
And talking about title belts, we see Rey Mysterio Jr. displaying two pieces of championship gold, because not only is he the defending WCW World Cruiserweight Champion, and that title is at stake as we kick off Thunder, he is also one half of the World Tag Team Champions, and there's a lot of intrigue about the matchup this Sunday at Spring Stampede involving Rey Mysterio Jr. defending the Cruiserweight title against Kidman. Kidman, of course, the former Cruiserweight champ, but at the same time, Kidman is also one half of the World Tag Team Champions with Mysterio.
You know, I guess I'm an internal optimist. I always look at the silver lining of things. It keeps your golf game in great shape. But either way, they're both going to walk out with at least one championship belt. And we'll see who's true. But these two guys are so close. I mean, Rey Mysterio and Kidman are so close talent-wise. The only scientific way to figure that match out and bet on it, if you knew a bookie, would be flip the coin.
I might be able to put you in touch with someone in Las Vegas.
I bet you would.
Off the quick cover, Evan Karagias gets a two count on Rey Mysterio Jr., and it is outrageous Evan Karagias in the challenging role. 25-year-old youngster. He's actually 1 year older than Mysterio, if you can believe that, but his in-ring experience pales in comparison to Rey Jr. Courageous has just been around for about 2 years as an active competitor. Missed that move. Opportunity now for Mysterio to capitalize.
Well, that's what he's up against, the speed of Rey Mysterio. I mean, to throw a drop kick against Rey is not a smart move. Rey is one of the fastest men I've seen. Now, he is small, but to wrestle someone, you got to catch him. Can Rey hold him down? And he couldn't hold him down.
Two count for Mysterio after the springboard and the leg drop connected with Evan Karagias. Larry, Thunder is going to be your news and information source, and I have a source at NBC Television that tells me that Bret the Hitman Hart, big power slam by Karagias, gets two, and Mysterio kicks out. Bret Hart is going to be appearing on NBC on the later program tomorrow night, right after Late Night with Conan O'Brien, and I understand that he's going to discuss in depth, as we see Karagias get another two count on Mysterio, why he quit World Championship Wrestling back on March the 29th in Toronto. I never expected that we'd be talking about this situation.
Where do you get your... So you got more sources than Carter's got pills here.
And I'm going to spill all the beans every week right here on Thunder. Yes, Bret the Hitman Hart. He'll be on later on NBC. That's Thursday night. If you're going to set your VCRs, remember it's Friday morning, 1:35 a.m., right after Late Night with Conan O'Brien. Not only will he discuss why he quit World Championship Wrestling, but also what it means for the WCW organization.
Well, I tell you what, Bret Hart, I mean, here's a guy that's very good, maybe a little on the cocky side, but you can't ignore his ability. Look at the frustrations. I mean, you got so many contenders here, and, you know, again, a criticism about Ric Flair and how he's hiding with the championship belt or whatever, which we'll be able to hide in four more days. But, you know, Bret Hart, again, one of these guys that do a lot of talking and a lot of crying, but it just, you know, I mean, shut up and wrestle already.
Evan Karagias trying to follow up his advantage out on the floor. Takes Mysterio, rolls him under the bottom rope, brings him back into the ring. Obviously, this youngster knows that if he's going to beat Mysterio and win the world's title, he needs to accomplish that in the ring. Drops down with his weight across the arm, the extended arm of Mysterio, and then just neutralizes him right in mid-ring.
Yeah, well, an arm's kind of a waste of time. You want to take out the legs of Rey Mysterio. You want to keep him on the ground here. Karagias, not enough pressure on that neck. Let Rey get back to his feet, and that's where Rey Mysterio is Rey Mysterio. He can move. Trap him in the corner, not a bad idea, but don't let him out.
Mysterio makes it to his feet, but Karagias unloads with a series of right hands. Shoots him off into the corner. Mysterio up top. Snaps off the flying head scissors. Ran right into the clothesline. Larry, I'm getting word that we're going to step aside here for a commercial break.
How come you get word and no one tells me diddly?
But don't go anywhere, because when we return, Rey Mysterio Jr., Evan Karagias, the world's cruiserweight title is at stake. Nabisco join you on a special Wednesday night edition, and we want to remind everyone that this special Wednesday night is a one-week change because Thunder returns next week to its familiar Thursday night, 8.05 p.m. Eastern time slot.
And I'm sorry, I have a tea time tomorrow, but I'll change it next week.
And we'll be talking later in this broadcast about bringing your Larry chance to Thunder, and the first opportunity that you will have is 1 week from tomorrow when Thunder is live in Orlando at the Orlando Arena. Believe it or not, tickets still on sale at the O'Rena box office and Ticketmaster outlets in Orlando. I can't wait to get to the Sunshine State and bring Thunder and Larry Zbyszko to Orlando, Florida.
Thunder's going to be great, and of course, I got a good buddy there, Paul, that works at the golf course, so we're going to have a good game. It's going to be a great day. I'm looking forward to it. And, of course, you know how they dress on the beach.
With very little, very skimpy.
Oh, it's hot.
Humidity picking up.
Picked up right there. Hey, for a man that's very quick, Rey Mysterio got caught twice, and we squirmed out.
Able to kick out that time. Hook of the leg by Evan Karagias in his attempt to take away the cruiserweight title from Rey Mysterio Jr., and it's not successful. The other blockbuster announcement from this past Monday, Larry, had to be that Goldberg will face Kevin Nash. And really, it has been inevitable. The two have been on a collision course ever since that situation that went down at Starrcade, where Goldberg's winning streak was stopped by Kevin Nash with a huge assist from Scott Hall and his taser gun.
Yeah, well, a huge assist is putting it mildly. Goldberg, no doubt, has Nash in his sights for a while now. I mean, it's a ridiculous blemish on a perfect record, which in my mind is still rightfully an undefeated record. But, again, you cannot underestimate Kevin Nash. He's a very confident man. When he gets in the ring, if you watch him, he uses his mind more than people give him credit for. Goldberg's going to have to be very careful if he wants to make Nash next.
Of course, those two men talked about that Starrcade match, the long-term impact that it will have on the rest of their careers. Nash will always be remembered as the man who beat Goldberg. Goldberg feels that as of late, he's been ignored. He's going to take matters into his own hands. And the two cruiserweights battle it out on the ring apron. Now Mysterio back in the ring. Big overhand clubbing blows to the back of Evan Karagias.
Well, some of that experience you talked about shining through right here, because Rey used the ropes as his friend. He got Karagias trapped coming back.
Whoa.
And that's an old trick, and he turned it into a new high-risk maneuver there. He just flattened Karagias.
He caught him in no man's land. Full leg extension, the leg drop, hook of the leg, cover, and a two count before Evan Karagias is able to kick out.
Yeah, too bad Rey's just not a little bit stronger. Hard for him to small package a bigger man.
Really has been an amazing run of success for Rey Mysterio ever since he lost the mask. And that time he connected with just the turnbuckle in the corner. Karagias was able to move out of the way at the last split second.
Yeah, that was a run of disaster there.
Karagias shoots him off into the ropes. High power slam lifts Mysterio overhead. Rey Jr. able to float over, catches a boot into the midsection. Now takes him up, gut wrench. Gonna bring him down. Oh, power bomb style. The back of Mysterio's head crashing to the canvas. Cover didn't hook the leg. As a result, he only got a two count.
Hey, eat your heart out, Harry Houdini. This guy could squirm out of positions a snake couldn't get out of. And he's lucky, Karagias. I thought he had him.
Front slam by Karagias. Headed out to the ring apron again. High risk move on the way. Mounting the top rope.
He caught him.
Rey Jr. cut him off at the pass and anticipated the move. Now can Rey Jr. take advantage? Up on top, Mysterio now mounts the middle rope.
See, Mysterio's home up here. He lives for this.
Rey Jr. up on top. Frankensteinered him back into the ring. Snapped it off, covered him, gets two, gets three, and he remains the Cruiserweight champion. Rey Mysterio Jr., still the Cruiserweight title holder, heading into Spring Stampede with a title defense against his arch-rival Kidman.
Arch-rival, huh? Could be a good matchup. These guys are both great, but right here, you know, Courageous, I think he made the same mistake. Big Sexy, we talk about Kevin Nash underestimating the ability, the gigantic ability of a small cruiser.
Larry, we need to take another look at Wendy's Big Slam of the Show is brought to you by Wendy's Big Hot Juicy Triple.
Well, right here, I mean, the slam provided by Rey Mysterio Jr. Courageous, hard to keep up with the man, the size and the speed of Rey Mysterio.
Wendy's, take your hunger out back, kick it in the face and push it off a cliff.
Talking about your ex-wife?
Now let's go back 9 days to Nitro in Toronto for Bret Hart's confrontation with Goldberg.